Shall we pray? Our Father, we are grateful unto you for the grace given unto us to listen to this message. And I pray that, Lord, you will speak to us. In the name of Jesus Christ, I've prayed. Amen. I'm taking my text from the book of Mark, chapter 16, verses 14 to 20. Afterward, he appeared unto the 11 as they sat at meat, and upbraided them with their unbelief and hardness of heart, because they believed not on them which had seen him after he was risen. And he said unto them, Go ye into all the world, and preach the gospel to every creature. He that believeth and is baptized shall be saved, but he that believeth not shall be damned. And this sign shall follow them that believe: in my name shall they cast out devils, they shall speak with new tongues, they shall take up serpents, and if they drink any deadly thing, it shall not hurt them. They shall lay their hand on the sick, and they shall recover. So then, after the Lord had spoken unto them, he was received up into heaven. and sat on the right hand of God. And they went forth and preached everywhere, the Lord walking with them and confirming the word with signs following. Amen. The topic today is Go Ye, Our Obedience. Go Ye, Our Obedience. When we look at the word Go Ye, that word is a word of command given by our Lord Jesus Christ. Our Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of God, He commanded the disciples that they should go into all the world and preach the gospel to all creatures. And when we look at this word, Go Ye, I've established that it's a word of command. And that word of command, the audience was the disciple. In other words, today, the same command is coming to us, the Christian, that we should go and preach the gospel. And this is our own obedience. That should be our positive response to what Jesus Christ has said. Now, in this message, I want to look at that word, Go Ye. It's a command given by our Lord Jesus Christ that we should go into all the world. In other words, the Jews and the Gentile inclusive. And when we look at the word of God in the book of Matthew chapter 21, Bible says that Jesus Christ was born that He might save His people from their sin. His people, that one is talking about the Jews. But now, when Jesus Christ was going back, going back to heaven, He was telling the disciples that they should go into all the world. That means He has everybody in His plan. Everybody is in His plan of salvation. And the second point I want to look at is that they should preach the gospel to every creature. This means that they should proclaim the good tidings. They should declare the good tidings to every creature. Everybody, Jesus Christ died for everyone, not only for the Jew. He died for Jew, He died for Samaritan, and He died for the Gentiles, including we Nigerians. He died for us. So we need to understand this one. And He said again that he that is baptized shall be saved. So this is our own work as believers. We need to preach the gospel. And when we preach the gospel, we need to disciple them and make sure that they really understood this message. When they understand the message, they will baptize them and they shall be saved. Then let's now look at something very special here. In verse 17, Jesus Christ said, "And this sign shall follow them that believe, that in my name they shall cast out devils." And we see here that Jesus Christ did not put the signs and wonder in the first place. The first thing that we should go out and preach the gospel. In other words, we see that preaching of the gospel is the priority, is the prime concern of Jesus Christ. And when we look at the book of Mark chapter 3 verse 14, when Jesus Christ called the disciple, Bible say that He ordained 12 that they should be with Him and that He might send them forth to preach. That is the reason why Jesus Christ called the disciple. But in the process of preaching, there can be signs and wonders. So we need to look at the example of the Apostle Peter in Acts of Apostles chapter 2, where he was preaching in the day of Pentecost. He was preaching, and what was the content of his preaching? His content of preaching was that Jesus Christ came to the world, He died for our sin, He was killed, and He resurrected. That was the thrust of the message of Peter. And when he preached this message, Bible said, and people were pricked in their heart, and they asked him a question, that what can we do? What shall we do? And he led them to the Lord Jesus Christ. So we believers, we should learn from this as well. And if you look at Jesus Christ again, in the book of Luke chapter 5 verse 15, Bible says that after He had healed the man, that leper, Bible said that so much more went after him, a fame abroad of him, and great multitude came together to hear him and to be healed. Great multitude came together to hear him and to be healed, which means that the first thing in Jesus' calendar, in Jesus' diary, is to preach the gospel. Then after that one, healing. Then we now look at our generation, the generation of the Christian, the contemporary Christian. We see in our posters, in our adverts, what do we publicize? Miracle, signs, and wonder. Thank God for that. But Jesus Christ's prime concern is for us to go and preach the gospel. To go and preach the gospel. Then now we now come to our obedience. And that should be our response to this command. Your response to the command of Jesus is obedience. My response to the command of Jesus Christ is obedience. And what is obedience? Is the heart of doing what you are asked to do. Is the heart of doing what you are expected to do. And I want you to know something. And it's a fact that he that cannot obey cannot command. If you cannot just obey Jesus Christ's instruction, you cannot command. He has asked us to go out and preach the gospel. And if you cannot obey that one, you cannot command any demon. You cannot command any demonic possession to be delivered. That is simple fact. I mentioned earlier on that Jesus Christ's audience were the disciples. Those were his audience. And we too, we are Christian. As he's commanding us to go out. Brethren, let us look at this. You cannot give what you don't have. If you have not been saved and you are part of the church, you are just mixed multitude. I want to invite you to the Lord Jesus Christ. That it doesn't matter your age. What matter is the time that you give it up to the Lord Jesus Christ. Come to Jesus Christ and you shall be saved. Shall we pray? Father, I thank you, O God, for this word that has come out, for as many that has heard the word and have responded by accepting you as a personal and Savior, I pray that, Lord, you will have mercy upon them and you will write their name in the book of life in heaven. And for all of us who are still part of the church and we have not been going out preaching the gospel, help us, O Lord, O God, to be obedient to your word. Thank you, blessed Redeemer. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Amen. My name is Reverend Kayode Akitunde, the pastor of Satellite Town Baptist Church, close 40A, Satellite Town, here in Lagos. The church is also known as Cathedral of Worship and Knowledge. We have our programs on Monday, 8 a.m. There's a prayer program we call Breakfast with Jesus. You are invited to this program. And on Wednesday, every Wednesday by 6 p.m., we have our program, Bible study, and a prayer program called Triumphant Hour. Then on Sundays, we have two services. First service commences 8 a.m. We have Sunday school 9 a.m. and second service 10 a.m. So we are glad to receive you. And as you come, the Lord bless you in Jesus' name.
Draw all men to yourself.